oleander, flowering tropical tree or shrub. Oleander is actually a member of the genus Nerium, and it is planted worldwide in tropical and subtropical climates for these wonderful flowers, which are very interesting in themselves. But the plant is thought to be native to the Mediterranean Basin. Must have full sun. It is very tolerant of dry conditions. It's often planted in the median strips of highways in places like California. You'll see them a lot in the Mediterranean region as roadside plantings, and also in parks and that kind of setting. For us here in the temperate zone, we must have them in a pot. They won't overwinter for us. Today we're visiting the Gardens at Cheshire, which is a company that overwinters tropical plants for people. And it's now late April, and this oleander is blooming nicely. This would not happen in your garden at home. If you happen to have a sunroom or a small greenhouse attached to the house, you could grow the oleander, but understand this. The oleander is not an edible plant. Every part of the oleander is poisonous. These flowers are interesting because they are nectarless flowers. They attract insects with the showy corolla at the end, but there's no nectar there. It's not often visited by pollinators. Some stupid pollinator bug that happens to be flying about might be attracted to the flowers, and that's how they will pollinate. But generally speaking, you don't have to worry about, for instance, beehives. If you have beehives near oleander, there is no problem with getting, you know, poisonous nectar in your honey. So the oleander is controlled by the size of pot that you grow it in. A pot this size will keep it to a 5 or 6 foot shrub. It will also grow, if you have a bigger pot, it will also grow into a tree form. Good example of a larger form of the oleander. Notice the roots winding around the pot. They do very well as a pot-bound plant. Many plants won't tolerate that kind of condition, but the oleander will. Nice sized trunk, beautiful plant. You can also weave the stems of oleanders into an interesting effect as well. The main thing about oleanders are these wonderful blooms. They're not really fragrant, they don't have nectaries, but they're a wonderful show for hot, dry climates. Oleander, Nerium oleander.
If you like this video, please subscribe and like and share.